There we go.
My mother got me
that.
Sick. My mom does have good sock taste.
We all need that, bro.
So is it good yet?
Yep. And we are back, folks. We've got Sunny T and Silver Triforce up first for you all. And so let's get this show on the road. Actually, Silver Triforce isn't doing too badly here. Just needs to find one good confirm to finish the stock out. That wasn't quite it. There we go. Following essentially all the way to the top of the stage to just finish the job. 65% is still definitely a deficit, and the bigger the lead the zoner has over you, the harder it is to come back. But Silver Triforce is starting to cut. Fine, close that gap, which can be a problem when you're the zoner, and because suddenly you're forced to be the aggressor. Silver Triforce keeping control. Ooh, great punish on the dash attack, and Silver Triforce now has the lead. Which is especially good against Duck Hunt, because Duck Hunt notoriously struggles to find the stocks.
This is very far to my left.
That's why I said left, bro.
Ooh, great punish. Exactly what Sunny T needs to get back in this game. Still, Silver Triforce retains the lead. Great dash attack through the can. Keeping Sunny T on the back foot, not giving him a single chance to get anything started. Finally gets the chance to throw out another can. Ooh, great clink and great down B. Oh, trying to fish for the stock with the forward air off stage. Here we go, getting some damage started on this is the last stock. Ooh, and the up smash, not quite enough, but close. Okay, that one is going to do it, Silver Triforce. Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Skins. This means that I can pick the favorites.
Ooh, Sunny.
If Panda Global wasn't gone, that would be a really good one for their stupid content.
Some great stuff from Sunny D, definitely putting up a better fight with Isabel right now. Still doesn't seem like Sunny T is quite ready for the down bees through the platforms, which is gonna be a problem. Oh, great turnaround. Did it. Unfortunately, dropped a potential chance to finish the job with an edge guard. But great call out on the landing there with the forward smash. Silver Triforce did a great job keeping the pressure at maximum so that even with the trades, they were not in his favors, but still not in that great position. Right, needs to find a stock. Another down B through the stage. Unfortunately, not going to get the chance to finish out with an up air. Oh, just barely missing with the side B. Forward air will do the trick. They have to play extremely well to take the game from here, though. Silver Triforce bringing it back for the match. What's the next match on stream? Okay. Mold? Mold? I think that we are playing on... That's what he said to do, so... So you want to come over for stream?
Where did the staff go? Are you playing the brawler?
Three, two, one, go! I lost to Michael Gaming. That's the freest matchup in the world.
Michael
Gaming.
I know.
But
it was pretty.
I know.
That's I'm gonna play Ant. You guys are up.
Oh, I play Ant? Let's go.
Okay.
Okay.
Hold
on.
There's your reach that hadn't taken a roll behind it.
Thank you. I thought you were going to move forward. I thought that was a bad smash. That's
Yeah.
What's the game count? Okay. Howdy. You ready? Yep, I'm ready. Go take a seat so I can get the cameras matched up. Oh, right.
Right away. I will. Thank you.
Oh crap, the stream crashed.
No! I hope the second game recorded, because like...
It wasn't, we didn't.
You zero to deaths me, and then I like zero to deaths you.
The entire thing was missed.
I didn't want to say anything, because I didn't want to like interrupt your
Dude,
set.
If the stream has gone wrong, notify me the moment the next game finishes.
Okay.
Can do.
Dude.
Thank you.
as far as one match.
The frame rate is pretty bad right now with what I did, so I could, but.
Oh!
I know. I'm setting up the...
Well, conversation we had. We had to talk 4 months back.
Hey, okay, you want to see my party trick?
Yeah.
Come here. Ready?
That's cool!
Whoa.
Insane! I
Logan and I actually watch this. The other day I'm ranked, I broke the shit. Oh, it's actually super good. Like edge guarding for finishers, because it's actually stronger. I'm pretty sure it's stronger than Mark's meat there. And it's also kind of in a way stronger than his tip repair, because his tip repair sends upwards, right? And so you want to.
Yeah, it's tough.
Boxes are just smaller enough.
And you have to be in tune. You have to play better than the record. I think you can, but it's tough. It is hard.
Oh my gosh! Stop being so sick. He doesn't have a
part of the
cup.
What's
the
point?
Did you not see the part of it?
Oh, yeah,
nice. He's not cool. He can't do it.
Thank you.
Also, if you're wondering what the issue was, I think it somehow fried one of the USBs, the USB port it was using, so I'm hooking it up straight to the computer. I got it back to working. The mic one, it was kind of working, but it was like at a like half the frame rate, so I was like, got the broken piece out and hooked it back up because don't want to have to force people to watch a GIMP stream if I don't have to. So this could be your night. Yeah. We'll see. I'll get back to commentating for now then. And we've got KJ versus Meek. The Zoner versus the Rushdown. Definitely an awkward matchup for Samus. So we'll see if Meek can take this. He currently has the lead. We'll see how long Meek can keep it. This goes for a down air. Back air gonna put KJ in a very bad spot. Ooh, bad dash attack. Interesting. Not going for the off stage ledge trapping pressure. I feel like that was a bit of a mistake. Then again, Fox doesn't have any great edge guarding, so pretty pure ledge trapping. Dash attack just barely does it. Didn't go for any further extensions there. Not chart shot, putting the pressure on, just runs up, gets the grab. Still, where's the stock gonna come? Forward air, just... Ooh, there. It's a great kill option, but it is punishable. Oh, going for a grab and not the up smash there, that's a missed opportunity. Not able to get the back air punish on the get up attack. And couldn't do an up smash from that position. There we go. up smash out of shield, just an incredibly good option for Fox. Oof. Yeah, JJ's trying to get something started here, and meanwhile Meeks is keeping up the keep away. Oh, trying to go for the charge shot read. Ugh, but Meeks finds one after all, but gonna put KJ in a bad position, just barely missing with that charge shot. That's so hard to get around Samus' ledge trapping, because it's just, but unfortunately gets the meteor hit on the up tilt, and so, as a result, not gonna take the stock just yet. KJ has a second lease on the stock. Oh, and up throw is absolutely going to just seal the deal. Okay, wasn't ready for a neutral get up. Oh, great! Just great jab there to turn the situation around, but now back on the side of the stage. Going for the... Okay, smart move. Didn't want up smash. Almost certainly wasn't going to kill there, but and so just going for the guaranteed damage is usually the better move in those scenarios. Still needs to... KJ is definitely showing hesitation on the up smash, which makes sense given that some of the earlier ones backfired. Still has to find the stock sooner or later, and is getting to the percents where anything can kill Fox. Good avoidance of the dash attack. Ooh, I think Meeks meant to do the back air the other way. Oh no! Yeah. Nope. Fox doesn't have a kill throw. Interesting. Trying to go for the gimp against Samus, but Samus is not gimpable for most intents and purposes. KJ's gonna has a lot of work ahead of him to take back this game. Oof, and the forward smash is absolutely going to do it. On to game two, Meeks tends to take a lot of time to think about the counter pick, which isn't inherently a bad thing. Because every counter, if you know how to counter pick right, you can turn the tide of a match very firmly in your favor. Oh, it's not Meeks this time. KJ doing it does it taking a fair amount too. Because it is challenging to counter pick too. Still. Stand by it. Meeks takes a long time to fit the counter pick. What? Going right back to PS2. Oh, KJ's coming out swinging, 65% to start. We'll see if he can keep up that momentum, though, because a strong start does not mean much in the grand scheme of things. Good punish. Oof, just barely missing the forward smash. Confirm. Dash attack. Okay, was not great punish by KJ there for the stock. Yeah, you have to be so careful when Fox is at close range of that, because up smash just has great, crazy KO power and speed. Back to neutral. Well, Tamik's badly wanting KJ to jump there, and they did not get given it to him. Tamik is just constantly charging the shot, just trying to fake keep Meeks, well, trying to keep KJ from getting the easy guess. Oh, my bad. Oops. Sorry. Oh dear, ouch! What a turnaround! That is a devastating reversal of momentum that could cost KJ this game. Okay, great run up and up smash. Just showing no fear. Sometimes it pays off. Do I have two mics on? Does it sound like I have two mics on now? If that's still a recurring... Oh, that's a bigger problem. If it's too robot-y, then I'll probably cease the commentary in a bit. But if that fixed it, then please do let me know. Back to the match. AJ Squat has the lead again, but Meeks has him on the back foot, which is never a position you ever want to be, especially against Samus. I don't know, that might be part of shield mode. Oof, Meeks finding the forward smash to take game two. Which, well, I'll have to look into that later. On to game three, Samus, White Samus meets with the color counterpick. The most pivotal of counterpicks. KJ, meanwhile, needs to stay in this game if he wants to advance to grand finals on winner's side. Otherwise, gonna have to go through Ant. Great punish on the dash attack. Gotta be careful. You cannot do unsafe things on shield against Fox. Really? KJ trying some edge guarding shenanigans. Good, gets the punish on the up B. Oh no! Trying to milk it for all it's worth. Gets back to neutral. Meeks very far behind this game. Granted, it could change, but we'll have to see. Ooh, great call out by KJ there on the charge shot. Built getting more damage. Oh, and KJ was not ready for that one. Not quite able to take the stock with that. Probably could have gone for the up smash confirm there, but I guess he was a bit nervous. Oof. Gonna eat big damage. Never mind. Meek's getting a bit greedy himself there and eats an up smash for his troubles. Turning, KJ turning things around with some good parries. Oh, good. Forward smash, a bit of an odd choice there and did not pay off. Ouch. Kit Meeks with a great read with that down air. Turning things back around with the up B, resetting to neutral, but now KJ has the advantage. Keeping it with that up tilt, finally gets the neutral reset. Unfortunate, KJ misses the chance to punish the roll, platform roll. Still has in a good position here. Back throw does it. Just barely. KJ's still in a strong position, but that doesn't mean that's far from everything. Meeks can definitely bring it back. Certainly on pace to do it right now, just keep, but can't afford to take too many of those hits. Oh, there's another reflect. Another reflect could be lethal. Oh, went for the wrong option there. Unless it was Min-Min, but another up smash does it. KJ with one on the board. We had a Min-Min on stream. Probably the last time we had, what's his name? Yin playing Min-Min. Going back to the gravity suit. Going to Battlefield. This is an interesting one because Samus does have ladder combo those, but also so does Fox. So I don't know who is going to get more out of this stage. Given that it was Meek's counterpick, he clearly thinks he will. We'll see if that holds up.
I wanted to beat Kid Mario as Yoshi. If I would Fox, it would be 2-3.
Oh, great. Oh, not able to get any further conversions there. Oh, and there's a big punish from Meeks with the forward smash. Interesting choice, running off stage to not give KJ any opportunity to press the invincibility. Just barely going too high, and they're gonna keep Meeks back. KJ not taking his time, not trying to go for anything too aggressive, but also for getting the range on that grab. Another great reflect. Okay, Meek's not gonna fall for the reflect that time. Up air, not quite enough from that platform. KJ getting caught, but gets a brilliant punish against the grab there. Just very expertly done that for KJ. Good shield, not letting Meeks build up a couple more damage. Oh, great shenanigans, just showing Meeks no mercy. Great combos from KJ there, and those were an awkward gun trade. very even on percents right now. Trying. KJ letting Meeks know I have a counter and I'm not afraid to use it. Can he psych him out successfully? Oh, dropped it at just the wrong time. Unfortunate. Nair almost does his trick. Not quite. Here we go with the... And yet goes high, avoiding the charge shot. Ooh, there's a good reflect. KJ now with the stock lead. Ooh, just barely stuffing out the charge shot there. Getting some nice damage. Bomb gonna end. A lot of things get back to neutral, but KJ starts it up again. Great conversion in off of that up tilt. And now, KJ with just a few more, one or two more hits away from the taking this game. Doesn't get the sweet spot on the dash attack, so not going to be taking stocks with it. Ooh, just barely able to shield in time. That could have been the game with that charge shot and made it back in time. Meeks calling out the landing with the grab and takes the second stock. Going to be a very uphill battle for Meeks to take this game back. Gonna have to play perfectly. Back air not quite gonna take it from mid stage, but doesn't have any room for error anymore. And that is absolutely going to do it. Game 5 online. Match all comes down to this. Whoever wins gets to advance to winner's side of Grands. The other will have to face Ant in loser's finals. KJ starting out with the lasers. Meeks really made the most out of that exchange. Upbeat punish on the dash attack. KJ puts him in the air. Oh, chooses the wrong time to get aggressive. Gets stuffed out by the charge shot. But great read to get the up air into up air. Oh, unfortunate, but manages to keep it going with a well-timed side B. Just going for the fort. Trying to fish for the back air, not able to find it this time. Oof! Great call out by KJ. Recognizes that the Zayr's gonna miss and punishing Meeks for being so close. There we go. Up tilts into up tilts. Oof, just barely taking the stock with that forward air. I'm surprised it's killed. And again, this is Fox we're talking about, one of the lightest characters in the game. Perhaps I shouldn't be that surprised. Can take stocks. Oof! The golden call out by KJ there, saving it for this last game, gets the a very early second stock going to put him in prime position to win here. Not sure what Meeks was looking for there. I think he was looking for KJ to jump or something, and KJ was just like, nah, I'm just going to hold shield. Great conversion, keeping it up with the building up more damage. It's going to take a miracle for Meeks to take this game now and match. Okay, go went for the grab there instead of the up smash. Odd choice, I guess. Didn't want to risk stealing it. There's a good back air, finally taking the second stock, though, still. Similar to last game, and at the position where no more mistakes can be made. And that is it. Just the Ume up smash, just finding its mark.
I just don't feel like I'm going to win. And then I got two buttons rolls when I was trying to cancel charge shot, and I was like, I don't know.
And up next, we've got Meeks versus Ant.
It's me and Dark Sun.
Oh, me and... Oh, Dark Sun. Oh. Is that... Oh, I got ahead of myself. Dark Sun. Sorry. Okay, so... I apologize for the error, but anyways, we've got Ant versus Dark Sun, so... Yep, losers semis. Yep, loser semis, thanks for the pointing it out, and for some reason it blocked that? I guess it thought that losers was being used in an offensive manner. Shield mode seems a bit wacky. Loser semis up. This is definitely a game of some where a very explosive potential. Some very wacky stocks are going to be earned in this match. The side B just has so much. It can force the opponent away, or it can control a lot of space. Trying to go for the. Oh, and there we go. 200% dead there. Dark Sun taking the first stock of this match. Oh, bounce? I mean, I guess it's a nice thing to have against the laser, so it's not as worthless as it is. So it's not worthless in this matchup. Also, sometimes heroes will go for balance even when it doesn't matter, just so it doesn't appear on the menu. Oh, great call out on the getup and just barely avoiding it. Great dodge from Ant there. Going for the side Bs. Building it up. Ouch! Dark Sun wisely not falling straight down into a smash. There's another bounce. Okay, good stuff, and that is still not quite enough. So Ant is on very low mana there. Gonna get thrown off stage again in this next short period, and that could be trouble. With Accelerator, maybe a bit less so. Back air forward, gonna just barely misses the edge guard there on Dark Sun, which probably didn't go as deep as. And another one of those does the trick. Overkill at that percent, but an overkill is still a kill. Just barely able to dodge that in time. Side B still not going to do it. Good light stall from Dark Sun there. Trying to go for the edge guard and just not able to do it. Great patience from Dark Sun there. Not going to eat the full charge shot, but forward air finally going to do the trick. Make the comeback. It is Hero, definitely a character who can get some extremely wacky stocks. So it's that's probably gonna do it. Game one to Dark Sun. Hey, that rhymed. Been around, I think. I could ask him where he's been later, but definitely not the time to ask at the moment. I think he's just been off his game, maybe? Well, we'll see. Going to Yoshi's story for the counterpick. I know that Dark Sun will sometimes counterpicks here, so interesting. Fair. There's a good grab. Gonna force Ant off stage. Ooh, missing the chance to actually hit the platform with that side B. Another good grab from Dark Sun. Trying to go for some lasers. Oh, unfortunate, went a bit too high for the down tilt to hit Ant. Oh, great air dodge from Dark Sun there, avoiding the charge shot just barely, though. That thing is also very janky, so it's possible he would have fallen out anyways. Now, when I say janky, I don't mean that in a good way. Another one, Dark Sun just playing around them. Great. Finally gets the back air to do the trick. One of the slowest back airs in the game, but it's still a back air. It has a big disjoint. There's and the back air to end the stock and the bounce. Ooh, Dark Sun on point with the air dodges. Gonna get the down throw into. And this time gets the deep call out with the forward air. And has the mana to afford to such a gamble. Yep, that's the danger of lasering that far from off stage. It's a great. Can be a good stall tactic, though, if the opponent reads it, you are screwed. If they can punish it, that is. Not every character has the recovery to challenge it. Oof, great back air from Dark Sun to clutch out the stock. Doesn't get the electric there, dropping the combo. It's an extremely close game right now. Went for the laser and got the bounce coming out just at the right time to counter the laser. Okay, interesting down air, just forcing Ant back, which, yeah, generally, that's the game. You can't be sleeping on the battlefield. So I guess that would be the Yoshi's Island, so, but triplats, they're all the same, right? Right? Yeah, going right back to Yoshi's. As I said, Dark Sun likes this stage. Dark Sun was clearly expecting Ant to continue the pressure and didn't. Here's the Accelerado. Another snooze. So soon after the last one found its mark. It's audacious, I'll say that. Oh, just barely not breaking the shield. Dark Sun barely held on to that stock. Trying to laser him twice. There's another Accelerado. Dark Sun taking his time on the platform and a great back air to close it out. Another well-timed bounce gonna cause Dark Sun some grief. Great spacing around it, trying to great stuff. Just staying just outside of Dark Sun's range and finally finds the chance to end him with the up B into back air. Dark Sun tried to get some revenge there, but not quite able to do it. Ant's interesting choice, doesn't he? Ooh, looks like he shot face the wrong way for that one. Ooh, great use of the lesser charge, catching Dark Sun in the air and snuffing out the second stock at a very early percent. Not going to give him any chance to get the rage drive. Oof, they're not quite gonna do it though. Gets the zoom to reset to neutral. Okay, interesting choice. Knew that Dark Sun was gonna dodge that up B and use the chance to get an Accelerado instead. Oof. Nope, not able to get it from that. And, oh, was that Boo? Okay, up B does the trick. Still has the rage drive online. So it could, Dark Sun could bring this back if he plays it right. Just barely avoiding the kaboom, but it looks like that did something Dark Sun wasn't prepared for and threw off his recovery. Ant now on match point.
Oh,
Interesting, was looking for the up B into up tilt trap loop. Nance definitely winning the zoning battle here. Dark Sun's not falling for Ant's up B shenanigans. Ant is fishing for that so hard. Right now, gets the accelerado. Let's see what Ant can do with it. Good up tilt, gonna keep him in the air. Needs to look out for the rage drive though, because that is instantly going to be the stock. Okay, great choice of down air to trap Ant and take the stock. Sniping another laser. And there goes the rage drive. Fished for it one last time and loses it in the aftermath. Not able to get the uppie into up tilt there. It's still struggling to finish out the stock here. It can be hard because nothing combos, so it has to be a raw hit. Forward air still not enough. Okay, Dark Sun. Cheeky play by Dark Sun, but Ant still able to recover, still. At least forcing Ant to use that much mana isn't a waste, total waste. Oof. Dark Sun calling out Ant's up tilt out of up B habit with that down tip air and takes the second stock. It's definitely going to be a tough battle for Ant to take this game, though it could happen. This is still Hero after all. Has some very wacky ways to take stocks. That good trade for Dark Sun, keeping Ant off stage. Ant continuing to fish for the uppies. Good punish on the accelerado. Still not able to get through after all. 73% is... Ant had a big deficit, though, with the right reads. Woo! Up smash, definitely not enough at that percent. And the snipe for game four. On to game five, it's all down to this. Dark Sun starts out coming, swinging. answering back with side B's into side B's. Now there's their accelerado getting gets the doom combo or the wall of pain. What do the hero mains call that combo? I just know it is, and it is ugly every time it happens. Woohoo! Almost takes gets the shield break with that. Good. Neutral B. Ant is firmly in control of the game right now. And gets the forward air to snuff out the second stock before Rage Drive can even get started. Dark Sun finally takes the first stock with an electric wind god fist into up smash. Needs to really get wasn't able to extend it further. Oof. Big kaboom. As the oomph. Not quite in the range of the sizzle for the damage. Just. Oh, Dark Sun was not ready for the cross up. Back throw, gonna put Dark Sun in awkward position. Gonna be forced to use a lot of mana there. Gonna be in a very bad position if Ant gets forced back off stage. Just try it. Down tilt. Well, down air does it barely. Good air dodge. Not another good shield. Has the Rage Drive online. Trying to go for the really aggressively edge guarding there, trying to snuff out the stock. Dark Sun going for the Rage Drive, doesn't find it this time. There's another accelerado, another miss. But each time it misses, it becomes that soon, and there it goes. Unfortunate, because that was probably one of Dark Sun's best tickets to cheesing this game. Now gonna have to rely on an electric wind god fist combo. Oof. Catches him with the kaboom and Ant clutches it out. Okay, I apologize for being presumptuous and forgetting that where we were in the matches, but in the end, it still proves to be Ant versus Meeks in Losers Finals. When a player can find the way to shut down every last option and seal the deal. Prepare yourselves, folks. Battle of the charge shots and battle of the zoners. This could take a while. Though they're very different types of Though still, there's a lot of difference between the two, so we'll see how well they can press their advantages. Meeks is definitely coming out swinging. Ooh, calling out the ledge stall with the up tilt. Then again, it is a there is definitely a significant amount of flowchartness to Samus's ledge trapping, so I guess maybe he just chose the right option. Ooh, the hero charge almost does the trick, and Ant finds the forward air edgeguard to take the first stock himself. Oh, almost gets the forward smash confirmed, but misses the chance. Great back air call out from Meeks, and just in prime position to take this game. No pun intended. Oh, great conversion with the... Ooh, and gets sucked into the kaboom. Not quite going to lose the stock for it. Ant, quick, unfortunately was not ready for the high and just barely avoiding the charge up from Ant. Dash attack takes game one with two stocks to spare. Looks off to a strong start, though. Can he keep the momentum? Or will Ant get the download and crush him? They both start out the same way, charging up their shots. Interesting. Not often you see Meeks go for the up smash just because it's not a very good move. It can be used for platform pressure. Charge shot into dash attack and a fourth. Meeks just barely getting caught by the kaboom anyways. Great forward air to keep Meeks off stage. Ooh, and just throws it out, catching Meeks off guard there and for the first stock. Looks like the forward air beat out the charge shot there. Good at the to avoid danger, and this is a stage that very much Meeks going for the up B to seal out that stock in a very bad position here. And good to hear Sharpie's still out there. I haven't seen much of him. Saw him like sometime last month, but otherwise. Well, maybe we'll see Sharpie again in due time. Back to the match. It is not looking good. Still, things are still not looking good for Meeks here, but slowly but surely finding his way back in.
Did you want the splash strike?
Sure. And there's a charge shot to take the second stock. Okay, that definitely did not mean to fire it, at least not like that. Just barely avoiding the charge shot that time, and trying to go for this F tilt, not enough to... Okay, suddenly we have a game on our hands. Oh no, Ant went for the lesser charged version and SD'd. Meeks? That was not a well, Meeks definitely earned getting back into the game like that, though. It's unfortunate when the game is decided by error rather than earning the stock. Yep, the mana matters. I don't know if he was totally out. It didn't look like he was totally out there. And it seems like Ant's a bit demoralized from that last game, and as a result, Meek's coming out swinging again. Oof. Almost getting it. That would have been a whack. I have to watch back to see if he was totally out or not. It didn't look like it from what I could see, but it is a possibility. That is something that happens with heroes sometimes. They use so much mana that they don't have it when they most need it. Still, Meeks is firmly in control of this game. Okay, good back air to close out the first stock. Okay, yeah, needs to keep Meeks from reestablishing himself on stage. Ooh, back throw not enough at that percent. Great punish by Meeks there with the Nair. If it was at zero, then that's that. Good punish from Ant there. Trying to go for this edge guard with side B of all things. Wow. I did not think he would have time to spot dodge. Good down air to keep Ant in the bad position. Up B, not going to be escorting him to the blast zone there, but going to do some damage. Oh no! That was painful to watch. Another. I'm not sure about the last one, but that game was 100% thrown with that air dodge. Sakurai, why?
I mean, I've been cheating before. Like, it sucks.
Are you able to
stop
Went to the I think he went to the bathroom, so we'll be waiting a bit for the next match. In which case, thanks again to Greed for this screen.
strong his character has gotten so much better. He's so happy right now, though.
I'm okay. All of, like, his middle side, like, yeah, it's good. But overall, you got it. When he's up on the thing, he's got the cloak hanging over.
Oh, it's nice.
Yeah.
Well, dude, okay,
and on to grand finals, Meeks on loser's side. KJ just going for the up smash for the most damage. An interesting choice.
That was the most important. Oh, yeah. Dude, what do you got?
JJ going for some great options for the maximum ledge trapping and not giving Meeks a chance to close out the stock. Gets the punish on the up B there for the first stock. Good reflect there from KJ, not taking the damage. Meeks needs to take the stock soon to take this game. And KJ is playing it very careful, playing around him very well right now. Oof, falls into the charge shot, and F tilt for the first stop.
Oh, you're not even close to me, you're literally lying to me.
I'm like
tap
one.
Yeah,
more than what
okay. Smart by Meeks. Never mind. Still finds a chance to up smash him out for the second stock. Not in a great position here, but it's not insurmountable. Oof, not enough damage to get the confirm into grab, and KJ is interesting to see him recognize situations where only the up smash can do it. Fair enough. Also, Oa, look forward to seeing you at Genesis next week. Meeks maximizing the pressure with the charge shot and the forward smash, but up air is gonna do it. KJ going into this match with momentum firmly on his side. Oh yeah, I know Ogre B. I knew him. Yeah, he is really dang good. Don't know where he's at these days though. Oh yeah, I think he went to Japan. KJ coming out swinging yet again, getting all the right reads. Oh yeah. I have zero doubts about that. Ogre B is cracked. He's got, has KJ off stage, and can he get back to neutral? It might, KJ has the percentage lead, but it's practically even just because that's Fox for you. Fourth, if I recall, fourth lightest character in the game, so always at high risk of losing stocks at some crazy early percents. But also can take him just like that.
Bro,
interesting observation. His lack of swing going the problem in this match. Like he's not going for enough kill options? Oh no, that is a definite stock. Meeks needs to do something fast before it becomes too much of a problem. Right now, though, KJ is keeping the pressure and not letting up. Good call out by Meeks there, but still not enough to take a stock. Good shield, but forward air, just not quite enough. Oh, just still not able to find the finishing blows. There we go. The downbeat. Yeah. Being able to shield at the right time is a key thing in this matchup, and it's also tempting to go for reflect a lot because of how big of a swing it can be, but if you rely on it too much, the opponent can find ways to punish it, so it's good on him to know when to go for that and when to refrain. KJ playing the match very well. And now on tournament point. Ooh. Seeing Meeks pull out the Crom. I'm not sure how I'm feeling. Not feeling it. Granted, this Fox is a character who can't really exploit Crom's recovery as much as some other characters. Though still, when a counter pick on their last game of the potential last game of the tournament, that's rarely a winning strategy. Still, by all means, prove me wrong. Oof, doesn't gets punished for the jab, and that is the first stock of the game. Okay, great jab into back air. Those have to be on point to get the most out of Crom. So it's good to see Meeks getting that off. Good get up attack. Gonna keep. Seems like Meeks is starting to get pushed back, and here we go. JJ getting some nice Oof. Jab gonna force Meeks back, and now at the real danger percents. And okay, Nick, I stand corrected. KJ got the edge guard, and that is going to hurt for Meeks. A good forward air punish, but KJ wisely, and but Meeks not so wisely, recovering to stage, giving KJ the chance to punish. Ooh, great conversion by Meeks there. Getting the nair into forward smash to clinch out the stock. So he's not out of this yet. Good call out with on the getting down from the platform. Still in a very, Meeks in a very bad position here. He's gonna be kept off stage. Has to play very carefully now because just one up smash should do it.
Yeah, no, I was the wrong way.
Back air, gonna force him off stage. Not able to recover. I think called it. Meek's counter pick did not pan out. And KJ is your tournament winner tonight. I don't know how he got there before I did, but oh well, congratulations to our players, and unfortunately I won't be able to stream next week because I will be out at Genesis, but so we are going to be having a Squad Strike side bracket though, so I'll keep the stream running for that. Anyways, until we get the Squad Strike on deck, I'll be putting it to BRB.
What did you say?
What is the teams? So Avery and Meeks are on the team, and what's the teams? What's the team? What are your tags? What's your tag? Shane? It's me. I know it's his tag is Meeks. So.
Read what she said.
What the hell? I said, interesting.
battle! Omotena! Ken! Donkey Kong! Donkey Kong! Go!
I am briefly bringing it back to Mike to call out our flowchart Ken on stream.
What up?